Remember when Obama pardoned a crack dealer? Let's remind Democrats what he did to three people. The liberal agenda is depending on you being ignorant. They depended on it to get Hillary elected, and that didn't work, but they're depending on it again to make you hate President Trump. Any seventh grade civics class could tell you what a president is allowed to do under national law, but every time President Trump does one of these things that he's supposed to do, the media makes it sound like he's going rogue and has to be stopped. They're framing the narrative to make you believe that the nation is spinning out of control. But we're not ignorant, and we prove that when we elected President Trump, and we prove it every time we hold the media or a dirty politician's feet to the fire on a clean-cut issue. We also prove it when we remember that President Trump is exercising the exact same executive privileges that every other president has, including Barry Obama. This might make for some uncomfortable conversations with the liberals in your life, but it's important to dispel this monster myth that the media is building of President Trump. Just this week, the president pardoned a sheriff from Arizona whose prosecution was hotly disputed for quite some time. Arpaio, who was 85, was found guilty of criminal contempt for defying a judge's order to stop traffic patrols that allegedly targeted immigrants. He basically decided to crack down on illegals, and the courts blasted him for it. President Trump decided that this senior citizen probably wasn't a huge threat to society, and cut him loose. This has enraged liberals beyond belief. But before you listen to them talk about how awful Arpaio is, or how egregious a breach in justice his release was, let's talk about someone that Obama put back out on the streets. Via Judicial Watch. A convicted crack dealer who left prison early as part of the Obama administration's mass release of federal inmates has been indicted by a grand jury for fatally stabbing his ex-girlfriend and her two kids in Columbus, Ohio. The gory crime drew national attention because the children, ages 7 and 10, were murdered to eliminate them as witnesses in the brutal massacre of their 32-year-old mother. This week, a grand jury in Franklin County returned a 10-count death penalty indictment against the ex-con, 35-year-old Wendell Callahan, for the triple murders. Callahan broke into his ex-girlfriend's apartment and stabbed the three victims, according to a statement issued by Franklin County prosecutor Ron O'Brien announcing the indictment. The bloody crime scene was discovered by the woman's current boyfriend, who subsequently engaged in a fight with Callahan before he fled. The indictment includes charges of aggravated murder with prior calculation and design and aggravated murder of victims under the age of 13. There are multiple charges regarding the three victim deaths because there are different methods to commit the crime of murder, and the prosecutor's office typically charges all methods, O'Brien stated. Callahan is in jail on $3 million bail and is scheduled to be arraigned later this week. Callahan should have been in jail when the crimes occurred, but he was released 4 years early because federal sentencing guidelines for crack dealers got reduced. The change is part of President Obama's effort to reform the nation's justice system as a way of ending racial discrimination. The initiative was technically launched back in 2010 when the president signed a measure that for the first time in decades relaxed drug crime sentences he claimed discriminated against poor and minority offenders. This severely weakened the decades-old law enacted during the infamous crack cocaine epidemic that ravaged urban communities nationwide in the 1980s. As part of the movement, the U.S. Sentencing Commission lowered maximum sentences for drug offenders and made it retroactive, leading to the early release of thousands of violent thugs like Callahan. In November, the administration began releasing 6,000 drug convicts, coined nonviolent offenders whose sentences were too long under the old guidelines. News reports quickly surfaced contradicting the administration's assessment that the newly released convicts were not violent. Among them was the leader of a multimillion-dollar operation that smuggled drugs from Canada to Maine. Prosecutors refer to the 29-year-old con as a drug kingpin who was one of America's most wanted. Shortly before the administration's mass release of drug convicts, federal prosecutors warned that drug trafficking is inherently violent and therefore the phrase nonviolent drug offenders is a misnomer. The nation's prosecutors also cautioned that reducing prison sentences for drug offenders will weaken their ability to bring dangerous drug traffickers to justice.